Welcome, viewers, to another stream for the Overwatch University League. My name is Dudge, and I'm joined here by today by Syndane. Give yourself a hello, my man.
Hello. I will just note this isn't actually a stream because we are scrubs and we can't stream. So this is actually a recording that we're going up on YouTube later.
Well, and for this recording, we are going into round 5 of Division 4 of the Overwatch University League with a game today between Team Weavestick and 420 Blazing Magic Mushrooms. Fantastic names from both of the teams there. What are we expecting to see today here, Syndane?
I mean, okay, so Weavestick run a quite an interesting comp in that they run Junkrat. They regularly, almost every single team competition they have, they run Junkrat. This is partially because it's Skowroki, who has 294 hours on Junkrat, and, you know, out of about 350 hours of playtime. So, you know, you could say he knows what he's doing there. But I'm really looking forward to this, because it's Junkrat. He's not meta. It's like you think Pharah normally does his job so much better, but they're running Junkrat, so I really want to see what they can do with this, and if there's actually any major differences between how they play around it and how they play around the Pharah. On the flip side, I know nothing about 420 Blazing Magic Mushrooms, other than it's quite a cool name.
Well, as you say, we are flipping up the meta a little bit today with Skowroki from Energy Beings Team Weavestick. This is, unfortunately, the first time that Team Weavestick are going to be subject to one of our casts. If you've heard us before, you may know that Energy Being is usually the third part of our tri-cast, or arguably the most important part, being our host, and a gracious one at that as well. But it looks like the action's already starting here. What are you thinking about these team comps here, Syndane?
Okay, so we've got the Pharah. That's a good pick if they've scouted, because who's going to kill the Pharah on Weavestick's part? I mean, I've heard Arex pretty good at doing it. Oh, there we go. We've got
instantly the action is going to be starting up here now as Koivupena with that Anna taking down the anti-meta pick of the Junkrat, but Arek managing to trade one back already as this action is happening on so many fronts already. One Reinhardt charge going straight into the back line now as he's going to be singled off from the rest of the team, but it looks like this fight is going to be going well from both fronts. Katsusha and VK on that Reinhardt once again, just doing whatever he can here, but the Genji taken down on the backside there by Statue. And it looks like VK is just going to be doing whatever he can with the backup of the Zarya in the backline of this fight, just holding by that little phone box. I was almost about to call it a post box there, but let's not get into that too much as Morgett's now healing up VK on the backside, but taken down instantly once again by Wybe as Ruti is clearing up this fight as he comes in from that soldier, just doing as much work. Skowroki now stuck within that hotel, not going to be able to get himself out just yet. Looks like this is going to be the first point already taken on the first push.
Yep, there we go. Scow, not impressed so far. Maybe they shouldn't play the Junkrat. Then again, we've got a tie coming up. Let's see what we can do with that. We've got Dragonblade, we've got a tie coming up. We've got close to an Earth Shatter, part of Weavestick, and we've got a Whole Hog. We're close to a Barrage, and again, close to an Earth Shatter, and possibly a Nano coming up. We'll see.
And once again, we are just seeing Arek doing as much work there on that Genji. Always nice to see Genji's jumping into the back line. No fear whatsoever. He knows he's got the support of the team on his back. But Katyusha instantly on that Zarya going to be taken down, as Wybe is now taking that as an opportunity to go through. But VK gets one hammer going through three members now as Arek channeling that Dragonblade, jumping into the back lines now, getting one, getting two. And this is going to be an almost team wipe as this first part of the streets phase is going to be completely and utterly held. And what a lovely hold there coming in from Team Weavestick.
Yeah, I mean they're pretty even in ults. I will say that was a dry push, I think. No, the barrage came out. Apart from the barrage, which I think was a mistake and a panic ult, that was a mostly dry push on the part of Magic Mushrooms. So they've got 4 ults here to the 1 on the part of Weavestick. So we'll see what they can do with that ult advantage.
And once again, this push is going to be coming through again, as it looks like the entirety of Mushrooms are just going to be pushing forward. VK going to be hooked in straight away by the Roadhog there. Arek once again cementing his position on that back line, just getting in there. Tanks ignoring him completely at the second. Energy going forward on that Lucio, going to be hammered down as three people are caught in the hammer of 420. Blazing Magic Mushrooms hammer as one Junkrat tire going to be defused in the back line of this fight. Katyusha just putting some damage down. Morgett's getting the ult. Resurrection coming through on two members there, as this fight is going to be pushed forward, the payload going forward alongside the fight, and it looks like both teams are now currently just fighting it out. That corner is going to be gained, but Arek with that Genji once again going to be using that Dragonblade, currently getting both healers now. Could both healers be being taken down, just completely and utterly hold this point for Team Weavestick? Well, it looks like that's going to be the case, as Arek just still slicing and dicing through the rest of the team, and this fight is going to be diffused with equal trades on both sides. Point on second corner now.
Yeah, that was a bit of a messy fight. Really quite fantastic play by Arak to save it, but they did end up losing the point in the end. They're getting pushed back here. I'm not sure we're going to see a hold. That Roadhog hook seems like it's not going to be held here. They look like they're going to look for the steamroll through. Looking for the barrage.
But straight
here.
Away, we are going to be seeing that tank visor coming in from Ruti as Arak is now contesting him on this balcony section. As that Genji doing as much work as he can to make sure that that tactical visor is defused. Katyusha now on that D.Va going to be pulled in. Ruti finishing off the kill on Gremlin as this is point taken. 2-0, 3 minutes 57 left.
Yeah. This is going to be a difficult one to hold. We've seen the Junkrat be swapped off for the Soldier here. I'm not surprised. I like the Junkrat, I really do. It's innovative-ish, but it's not. It can't really deal with a fire at all, especially not in wide open spaces like this. Because Junkrat can jump up to a face, but you're kind of relying on the Genji and the Zarya to do your work for you there.
And once again, it looks like this fight is going to be starting as Skowrokey instantly switching over to that soldier. Instantly going to be taken down by Jontsai as he's going to be trying to get a flank on, but not really accomplishing too much there. VK charging in, only got the support of Arek at the second, as it looks like the enemy Reinhardt is going to be jumping down and getting into that back line as well. Energy now channeling his ult as well to try and get as much of a teamfight advantage here as possible, but it looks like this teamfight is going to currently be going in the favor of Mushrooms as Arena is now on that Reinhardt. He's got that nano boost, he's got a hammer, and he's turboed. He's going to be trying to get whatever he can, but zoning off Skowrokey at the second as Arek, the only man with that Dragon Blade on the back line, doing what he can as once again another Mercy Res coming in, getting another two members to try and cut through the rest of this team and try and defuse this team fight. Looks like this is going to be a hold for now.
Yeah, I mean, that Arek was just so desperately trying to get that Dragon Blade. He was jumping in, he was meleeing, spamming that right click, and then he got it and just instantly popped it and went ham on the back line. Quite spectacular play from him. Oh, Katyusha!
And once again, we're still going to be seeing some more game-changing Roadhog hooks, but that one might not be so game-changing now as the Rocket Barrage is coming down onto two people at the second. Justice raining from above and taking down two, whilst we're going to be seeing the rest of Mushrooms get this push coming through, currently in the 6v4 situation, and doing whatever they can. Skowrokey getting a lovely shield there from Katyusha in the back line of this fight, as it looks like Jontsai with that whole hog is going to be going nuts. The Ham is doing whatever he can, going to be slept on the back line as well, though, as Skowrokey once again is going to be taken down in this back as Ruti comes through with attack visor, getting a lovely 3k. Jontsai cleaning up the rest of the fight. That's going to be round one.
Okay, so that wasn't a good hold by Weavestick. I've talked to them about this. I've spoken to them about this before. That was, not a huge fan of their team comp there. I like it. I really do like the comp on attack. Not a huge fan of it on defense. Arek was doing work on the Genji, but yeah, they just couldn't really capitalize on any of the trash damage that was coming through. Right, okay, so we've got that same comp coming out with the Winston instead of the Reinhardt, and we have pretty much a counter dive comp coming out here from Magic Mushrooms there with the Reaper and the Roadhog. That Winston's not going to have a good time.
Speaking of not having a good time, it's kind of difficult getting the full name of Magic Mushroom's fantastic name into this cast. I'm finding it quite difficult to put 420 Blazing Magic Mushrooms into the full sentence there. But with these team comps that are going to be cemented now, with 420 Blazing Magic Mushrooms on the defensive side now, what do you think they're going to have to do to defuse the heavy push style that we do come to expect from Team Weavestick?
Okay, so what you got here, you've got the Winston has to go down very quickly. They've got the setup to do it. They've got the Roadhog, they've got the Reaper. That Winston has to die in a matter of seconds. They've got the comp to do it, they just need to execute it. But at that, and I think Anna's sleep dart, if that lands on a critical target and isn't immediately woken up, that will also be crucial in emasculating the push, for lack of a better term.
Emasculating the push. Well, we are going to be seeing quite a nice little diverse roster coming through from Team Weavestick, who are going once again with the Junkrat. We're also going to be seeing the Anna and the Lucio on the side of healers. No hit scan coming through from the damage sides. Arek once again sticking to the Genji, and our tanks for this push are going to be Winston and Zarya. Going to be a nice little dive combo coming through here. So fight's already going to be starting as VK jumping straight onto that point with Arek, both on the same page as one another as they're trying to get in and do as much work as they can. VK jumping around, but not doing enough of the jumping. That jump pack not going to be getting him skedaddling anywhere else as Wybe taking him down. Looks like this first push is going to be completely and utterly foiled.
Yeah, I mean, they got. I mean, ult-wise, Magic Mushroom's got more out of that, especially on the healers. One of the issues that you have with the Junkrat, he does so much trash damage. Oh, and here we go again.
And once again, another fight coming straight in onto the point as Aramea is the first person taken down. Reinhardt out of this fight. You've got to consider that some damage is going to be coming through with that portable shield now being out of the equation. Rooty on that Reaper going to be diving around, going ghostly at this moment in time as Katyusha is taken down on the backside by the Roadhog. Skowrokey pressing right click after pressing a shift and getting a kill. Arek being hooked in but managing to defuse that and completely turn that on the aggression of the Roadhog there as this first point is going to be taken by Team Weavestick.
Yeah, there we go. Well-executed dive. They're coming out here with an ult advantage. They should be able to roll this through to the second point. Well, one should hope.
VK now pushing this forward, making sure that no further aggression is going to be.
Yeah, I don't like that. That's a bit risky. He's done nothing except build himself some ult charge there, and he risked dying, especially when they've got Roadhog Reaper.
Well, maybe we will be seeing the monkey go ape in this next fight coming up as that ult is soon going to be going through. We were doing whatever we can here as Aramea gets one or two members with that Earth Shatter, but only managing to take down one. Rooty finishing off that Junkrat Tyre on the back line. Not the very best of attack ults, as this attack is going to be foiled just for this moment in time.
Yeah. Excuse my terrible camera work, by the way, viewers. I am not used to doing it. Trying to get some first-person things and ending up stuck to someone's rear end for a long period of time.
And this is where energy usually carries our casts, from the front-end side as well. And speaking of carrying, this is going to be going another fight going through. Aramea getting the charge in, and we've got the Nano Blade now coming through. This is going to be a Turbo Weave going into the back lines as he's doing whatever he can, swinging that sword. He's got a range of a sniper rifle on that. VK jumping into the back line now, doing whatever he can, but this is going to be the Beyblade coming out on the backside as Rooty takes down three. Katyusha finishing off Rooty in the end, but VK is going ape, and he is doing it indeed. He finishes off Bamboo Sansa on the back line. That Lucio being taken down. Zarya, the only person left to really aggress this point, but it looks like Weavestick have just managed to get themselves together nice and quickly as Arek once again jumping in onto the back line. This Genji is going to be a ninja, and he's going to do some work. Energy being finishing off that kill on Wybe.
He's almost got
Arek
ult back.
Once again finishes off the healers.
He's almost already got ult back. What are you doing, Arek? What have you been eating? Other than Mercy Mains.
Well, he may have had his fill of ramen today. Naruto is coming out and jumping straight into the back line of this fight once again. Going to be using that deflect to try and get as much damage reflected back onto the enemy team as possible, as this point is going to be taken with ease.
Mm-hmm. And again, we're just seeing ult economy, the really good ult economy by Weavestick here. They're coming into this point with three ults to the... three coming in on that side, but they're winning the fights. They're
momentum
not overusing ults. They've got a nano coming up as well soon. And I say that. Are they going down? Here we go.
Momentum here is still going to be coming out as Wybe is trying to counter that momentum on the backside. Tactical Visor only getting Skowrokey on the backline at this moment, but Rx slicing through him once again. He may be Sasuke on that backline, but he's got to get back with the rest of the team, and so he can do some work. But VK just trying to jump in to regroup, but not really anything else coming out of that first push. Momentum foiled for now.
They didn't use any of their own ults. They've got a Primal Rage coming up in a second. They're close-ish to a beat drop. And they did get the TAC visor out, so we'll see how that turns out, that was a dry push.
And VK once again charging straight in, firing at will. Rek going to be using that blade once again. 1-2 and 3 kills. Sasuke going through the rest of this team once again, as Wybe is also going to be taken down, but energy being taken down by Rooty on the backside of this whole hog, managing to kill off the Skowrokey's Tyre there. And also Rooty using that rocket barrage to get 3 kills to defuse that ult push once again.
Mm-hmm. Once again, we see the issue where you, against Pharah, if you don't have a hit scan, It's risky. You're really relying on that Ana. I'd like to see a Zenyatta come out after this beat drops used by Energy Being, just to assist with taking down that Pharah, because she seems to be their main issue. Like, if you look at Fire, only one Fire.
But we have to draw attention to this hold that is being drawn out. It looks like Mushrooms are just doing their very best to stay together through these fights. But as I say that, Jauncey is taken down. But it looks like the team, once again, showing that they can coordinate very well as they take down two on the backside of this fight. That payload is not going anywhere soon. This isn't a supercar. But Rooty, once again, doing some damage on that backline as Arek takes taken down once again.
Yeah, again, that looked like a dry push. They're just trying to build some alt charge for the last push. They're going to come in here with a beat drop, probably a Reptile later during the fight. They've got Primal Rage and they've got a Blade. No Nano, no Graviton. The Graviton would be really useful here. It's such a big ult.
Shield is now being held up as VK leading this charge once again, donning the boxing gloves, going ape, jumping onto this backline. Beat is now dropping. Looks like the entirety of Mushrooms are going to be pushed back. This payload going to be pushed forward at the same time. Aramea on that... Reinhardt, I was almost about to call him Roadhog there, but you cannot mistake a German for a monkey. As Jauncey throwing out that hook, but landing only into the shield of the Winston at the second, as it looks like this final push is coming through. Four or five people on that point at the second. Nano Visor, Nano Boost coming down now onto Rooty, who is going to be landing some damage into this backline. No shields to protect him from there, as Scalroki is taken down. Energy being booping, Boopsander right off there, as Morgette also taking down his counterpart. This is a kill of doppelgangers, as once again, another lovely Earth Shatter is going to come through, but no real follow-up. Only one kill traded out of that, as D.Va, the only person alongside a Tracer now, jumping around this point, trying to secure time, trying to push this a little bit further back. We've still got 1 minute 20 on this clock to go, as VK doing every single thing he can on that monkey, as one more rocket barrage is coming down from Rooty. Once again, VK is going to still be going ape on this back line, doing a lot of work now, as Aramea on that Reinhardt is just going to be having a battle of the shields, battle of the tanks, going ape once again, that ult charging very quickly, and it's going to be VK just jumping around as if this is the zoo.
Do monkeys normally jump around like that at the zoo? I must admit, I've not been to one in a while, but that doesn't match
well
up.
When they're excited, and it looks like this man is very excited, as another fight is already going to be starting again here. Vibe going to be going purple as he's just going to be running around, puts that pulse bomb down, gets two kills from his entire engage, and it looks like the rest of Team Weavestick here are going to be having to go back onto that defensive with only 30 seconds left. Yeah. We have to expect this will be the last push coming out of them.
Yep, they've got the Graviton. That's big. Oh shit, that's crucial. That is crucial. Arek's just gone down to the D.Va.
Crucial enough to turn this from a family show into another festival of swearing, and it's going to be the Turbo Monkey going down onto this, as he's going absolutely ape without going ape in the backline, firing at will into there as the D.Va self-destruct comes in, takes down two as it's put onto that payload. VK still safe as he's pushing this point, staying slippery. I didn't know monkeys were slippery. Maybe he's coated himself in butter, but one person taken down as Aramea takes down. Oh, Jauncey taking down
there
VK
we go.
On the backside of that. Arek.
Game one to Mushrooms.
Woo!
One question I'd like to ask of you, Dutch, is if you think this is a long name, have you seen the team we're casting later?
Yes, I have. And
for our viewers, that is, hold on, I have it written down. It is the Plenary Meeting of the South Pole Friends.
Yes, it is. I'm sure there are many jokes that I'm going to be able to have to think up before that game starts off as well, as we're going to be seeing another lovely tactical visor coming out, which wiped out that fight and cemented the push from the first round there. And what a fantastic game that we did see. Very equal. And what do you think did go wrong there for Team Weavestick to not be able to close the second round out?
Honestly, I think they underestimated the enemy team. I think they would have been better off putting Arek, because he can play the soldier. He's a very good soldier. Put Arek on the soldier, throw Scout on his Reaper, which is, I happen to know, is very good, and just defend with that, because the comp they were running, good on attack. It works well. It works well for them. It suits the players they've got. But, and this is a big but, you have to be better than the enemy team to pull it off against all comps. One of the most important aspects for a defending team in terms of composition is that it can deal with anything that comes at you. They did not have an answer to deal with a very, very well played Pharah by Rooty. And yeah, I think that was the main issue there. Their ult economy impressed me, but I actually just think they were lacking in terms of options.
And for options, we are going to be going over to Hollywood for the next map. Mm-hmm. What are the options for the pushing of this this map in particular, the first pointless
phase? Again, dive comp, because this is probably the best map to run Symmetra Torbjorn on. And against Symmetra Torbjorn, what you have to do is you have to win on the first push. Oh, well. You have to win a team fight on the first couple of pushes, otherwise they're going to have a teleporter down, they're going to have Molten Core, they're going to be able to stall you to high heaven and stag, and if they stagger their ults correctly and teleport usage. And is that a Torbjorn? Oh, Kyoku, you're just messing with me. Okay, let's not talk about them then, because they're messing with my head. Let's talk about Magic Mushrooms. Fairly standard comp. They've got the Reaper there in anticipation of a dive. They've got the Soldier. They've got the Roadhog again. This worked for them before. I don't see why it wouldn't now. Although, yeah, and on the attacking side, we've got Skowrokey on the Reaper rather than the Junkrat. Bit of a shame. I do like the Junkrat. On the other side, I do think Reaper is a stronger hero right now.
Do you have to expect that coming in, taking the Reaper on Rooty first, that the team is already expecting a dive comp coming through on another hybrid map, two in a row, two dive comps in a row as a potential there?
Honestly,
this is an answer.
Yeah, honestly, I wouldn't be surprised. Rooty's shown that he can play the Pharah pretty well, although Pharah is obviously more traditionally played on attack. We, to my knowledge, haven't actually played anything else, so this might just be a case of scouting. So, we'll wait and see. They did still get rolled, even with the Reaper and Roadhog comp, which they had last game. So, we'll see how well it plays out. Last time we took a switch to the Pharah for them to manage. So, looking forward to it. And here we go.
And once again, we're going to be seeing Genji on this. So this is going to be some fantastic Weepstick action coming in as True. Once again, the Firestrike going through three members, already getting a little bit of ult charge there. A little bit, quarter of the way there already. But this Genji is... This Reaper is already coming in on the back line. Going to be going purple from Morgetz's healing grenade there as he's trying to regroup with the rest of the team. First push now coming through, and it looks like Aramea is already going to be taken down, but trade kills across the board going straight in favor of Team Magic Mushroom.
Reaper versus Reaper, and Reaper wins.
Who would have guessed it? As we're also going to see Weeb take down Weeb? We're going to Weeb take down the Reaper of Skowrokey in the back line of that fight as well. What do Team Weebstick need to do to, with this composition, to get in to the back lines and take this first point?
Honestly, not that. Not that. That needs to not happen.
And that's going to defuse this push. They were going to be going through the back alley segment of this map, but instead choosing to regroup at the choke point once again. And with this hold that's coming in from Team Mushrooms, it's very uncommon to see in something like Quick Play teams to be holding here. Why would they be holding so far back in the competitive environment?
Mm-hmm. So, hold on a second, we've got fight. I will explain this.
Well, once again, we're going to be seeing the fight come through as Energy Being jumping into the back line, going to be supporting VK on here as Arek is going to go purple on that Genji. Skowrokey taken down instantly by Rooty. And I got the name right this time, but Arek going to be slicing through Aramea. And it looks like this fight is going to once again be going in favor of the team of Mushrooms. But VK just channeling that ult. Going to be donning those boxing gloves and seeing what he can do. And I used yesterday, float like a butterfly, sting like a monkey, but he's not going to be stinging too much here today as Arek is going to be jumping through the back of that dumpster, going back through the back alleys as the teams are just going to start regrouping again and start fighting straight away afterwards. This unrelenting aggression as Aramea lands a lovely earth shatter onto the back line of Team Weebstick there as Arek is going to be going for the Team Turbo Weeb as the Turbo Weeb is going to be jumping in, trying to find as much as he can. Jauncey almost going down. Arek already taking two. That sword going to be doing a lot of work. Aramea doing a lot of work with the hammer instead. Arek now also taking down a couple on the backside as this point is going to be contested by 3. VK now jumping in to support the rest of the team as Aramea, the only person left alone, and he is the only person on the backside of this fight to go down. VK just trying to push out the rest of Team Mushrooms, stop them from getting to this point once again.
Yeah, we're actually seeing 3 DPS come out. Yes, thank you, Phoenix, I do know. We're seeing 3 DPS come out here, which I like. It you don't really strictly need a second tank with the wizard. Oh, here we go.
And Tactical Visor coming down, layered straight on top of that Death Blossom as Rooty is going to be going into Beyblade mode and doing whatever he can, but it's going to be two kills taken down, 4 kills, 5 kills, 6 kills, and this is going to be a hole at the very last pixel of that checkpoint.
Skin of their teeth.
Seconds left.
I thought I had that. Yeah, so tanks, their main job is to create space and protect their team, but when you've got a Pharah, a Genji, and a Reaper, to a certain extent not Reaper, but they will protect themselves. They make their own space. So, oh, here we go again.
And space is going to be invaded straight away, as we're going to be seeing counter ults coming in across the board. Skowroki also going to go into Beyblade mode and take down Bamboo on the backside of this fight, as Orek also going to be taking down the healer. Both healers down once again now, as it looks like the rest of the team is going to be crumbling. And Rooty, the only man left, not going to manage to get anybody, as it looks like the rest of the team are going to be healed up
there once again
by more gets on that Ana.
They do take the point. Okay, so back to what I was saying about where teams hold. The reason for that, honestly, is just because it's too open. They can poke freely. That's basically it. There's a bit more to it than that. But I'd like to get back to what's happening right now, in that they're sticking to the 3 DPS. So.
And it's going to be more action across the board straight away, as it looks like the unrelenting aggression of Team Weebstick is going to be going through. Rocket Barrage on the backside of this fight as well, going to be taking down another two members. Only 2 kills traded back. This is a 4-2 kill trade at the second. And it looks like, just to prove me wrong, cast a curse once again, as it looks like this is going to be an easy corner for Team Weebstick.
Yeah, coming out to the second corner now, they're going to have a fight for the last point, but if they can win this team fight, which they've got the ults to do it, then yeah, they can do it.
And VK instantly onto the back line, going to be contesting with 3 damage dealers.
Oh!
And it's going to be, once again, another Earth Shatter coming down, as RMA are going to be doing a lot of work on this back line, but another Nanoblade coming through on the backside of this fight, as 1 kill is taken down, and he's taken down himself. Sasuke, you lost this fight, my friend, but it looks like this fight is not going to stop overall. Tactical Visor now also going to be channeled by Wipe, as he's trying to zone the rest of the members of Team Weebstick around the corner of the saloon, but VK does not care about that. He's a monkey, he's jumping in. Katyusha still taking to the sky, raining damage down from above and doing whatever he can, as it looks like this point is still going to be contested, but the rest of Team Weavestick are now pushing through into spawn advantage. But Bamboo Sander takes down Skowroki's Reaper ult almost instantly of it being cast. That Reaper ult not doing any work, but VK doing work on the backside of that fight, instead taking down Wybe on that Shult Soldier. Now going to be taking a little bit of a nap and going purple on that payload, breaking it down now from Energy Being as they're pushing forward and doing whatever they can. VK is now going to be going 8 on the back of this fight and jumping in once again, jumping around, punching every single person he can find. This man is angry and this man wants this point, as it looks like John Sawyer is going to be going whole hog, nano hog on the backside of this fight, as the counter ult from Lucio is going to secure this team fight victory once again for Team Mushroom. Aurek doing what he can, nano Dragonblade up once again as he's slicing through everyone. Katyusha's ult is going to be cancelled through that channel. RMA the only point man left on this point. His shield is not going to protect him from all of these members. He needs more hammers, he needs more hands, and it looks like Team Weavestick are going to cement this point.
Okay, that was an awesome
15 seconds
fight.
Left.
That was an awesome fight to watch.
That was a fight which just didn't end.
No, that was
fantastic.
Are we sure this is only 6v6 and not 12v12? That's what it felt like.
That game mode will come out one of these days, and I'm really hoping we get some bigger maps for something like that.
That would actually
to
be awesome.
But we are now going into the studio section of this map. And what is this point usually known for, Sindang?
Honestly, stalls, you see a lot of fires. You see Mei. Mei is pretty big here. I'm expecting a Mei swap from someone here on the defending team. We might see Reinhardt going, oh, Rooty was looking for a chance to take out Death Blossom and ended up dead himself. And
this fight is going to be spread all across the board, as it looks like Team Weavestick are slowly getting the better. VK just going to be jumping out, getting a nice little bit of a twirl there. I didn't know he's a ballet dancer as well. But the rest of the Mushroom team are going to be pushed back into the caravan section. Another Dragon Blade coming through as Rooty is just trying to clear that area, only taking down both healers, but that is going to cement this fight. Arek also taking down another two with that Dragon Blade, and VK now also going to be going ham onto this point as Aramea, and again with the Earth Shatter, he's getting these so quick, and Rooty is getting the kills on the backside of those Earth Shatters.
I'd like to see that more. We see a lot of teams just nano the Reinhardt whenever some form of CC's gone out. If you've got a Reaper, throw it on that Reaper. He can do so much more with it. And we see Rooty here. He's just trying to stall. They don't want him to go into overtime. Don't think they can stop it, though.
But 10 seconds left, as we're going to be breaking it down once again, as Energy Being trying to channel his inner Rap God, as it looks like the rest of his team are going to be going purple on the backside of this fight. But Bamboo is going to be jumping around as that Lucio being the annoyance, as Johnsoy going to be taken straight out of Divamech. Divamech's now scrapped, and he's going to be just a mini Diva, not going to be too effective in these fights, as Bamboo Sander is also taken down on the backside. Katyusha now just delaying these spawns, as it looks like that is going to be the straight take.
Okay, so yeah, so most of that was in first person view because I have this weird thing going on with the camera where as soon as I detach from a person, it decides the sky is what it must lock onto. I'm not quite sure why.
Hollywood is a lovely place, and I imagine the sky here is
it very is still
pretty.
Doing
let's,
it.
Let's give it a nice little look. Let's take a look at that Hollywood sign. Very realistic. Looks like whole V wood more than anything else. But that aside...
Hold on a second. I know what this is. My controller was plugged in and was knocking and was pointing to the sky.
Ah, fantastic. So, now we've got that sorted, technical issues aside, what do you think that Team Mushrooms are going to be needing to do on their push to get either a better time or to take it all the way to the bank and take this to a round three?
Mm-hmm. Honestly, if we're looking at the... If we're looking at just compositions, they should run the Pharah. Weebstick have shown that they can't really deal with the Pharah, and Magic Mushrooms are very good at playing around it. They're good at finishing at confirming the kills the Pharah's damaged. They're good at setting up Pharah for her barrages. They just work well with her. But they're not running her. They're opting to run a variant on Dive here with Tracer, Winston, and the Soldier. I'm not a huge fan of this. I feel traditional Dive is obviously Winston, Tracer, Genji. If you're only running one of those, it's generally the Genji to confirm the kills and for the verticality, rather than just the Tracer. Maybe they've got a plan here, but they're running the Pharah as well. So, okay. They're mixing up what they want to play. Okay, they're going with Pharah, Soldier, and Winston. Not a huge fan of that. Soldier kind of likes a Reinhardt to hide behind, especially on the attack. We're seeing a fairly standard comp come out here, although they have replaced. Okay, they've mixed up who's playing what, and I'm very confused.
Well, maybe that confusion will go aside slightly different, hopefully soon, as Skowrokia is going to be holding the shield wall on the high ground this time. Katyusha and Wybe.
Oh,
and a lovely boop coming down there from Wybe as he just takes and negates of that high ground advantage. Verticality not being a point here now anymore as Rooty takes down Katyusha with the Helix Rockets of all things. What a lucky... Love it, man. Lucky, lovely,
lovely.
Either way, it was a lovely shot on the backside and a pretty bit of fireworks.
How did the wreck get there?
Rooty once again with those Helix Rockets doing work with that DPS in the backline as Wybe, the only person left to try and contest this point and just get some more damage down, charging his ult up lovely as he does this, taking down Energy Being, as it looks like this is going to be an easy take for Mushrooms.
I'd just like to point out, a wreck on Roadhog somehow ended up behind enemy lines. Guys, Roadhog is not a flanker. I don't know how you got there, but don't do it again.
Well, he's just done it again, just for you. A nice surprise and a present for you as well, as this first point is going to be taken with plenty of time to spare by Team Mushrooms.
Yeah, I mean, it's not my birthday. You don't need to get me anything. Okay, so just really good team fighting play by Magic Mushrooms there. Weavestick didn't really have a response. I don't like how they switched up who's playing what. That kind of goes against the point of building team synergy. Why is Skowrokia on the... Like, they could run this composition without... while having people on the heroes they normally play. I'm not sure why they're doing this.
VK still going to be on that Genji as he's just jumping through these back lines, getting as much damage down and trying to stall this point out as much as possible, but this payload is still driving through the street section here. This studio is going to become a horror film now as VK is going to be getting that nano blade on the backside, taking down one, taking down two. Tactical visor also coming through from Rooty as he's just zoned out instantly by RX Whole Hog. Rooty still managing to find two on the backside of that zone or not, he will kill you. He has you in his sights as Johnsoy pushing this charge through the middle of the street section. Rooty now chasing off Energy Being on the back end of this fight.
Yeah, they don't really seem to know what they're doing or being able to prioritize targets. You saw Rooty get down to about 10% health, not be finished off. They seem to just be panicking and swapping out heroes randomly now. I'm not quite like yeah now now Arek and Vika and Kyoku have just swapped heroes.
As we're going to be seeing another fight come through instantly. I'm sorry to interrupt you on that point, but this is going to be a lovely one as the Rocket Brawl just coming down. It gets two, and this is going to be an ult commit to secure this second point.
5 minutes. 5 minutes they've got to hold this for.
You said earlier about stall. What sort of stalling are Team Weebstick going to need to do here to try and buy time?
Honestly, not right now, but when they get to the point, I expect we'll see a Bastion coming out to cheese. I'd like to see a Mei now. I'm not seeing one. Not so
Kyoku
far.
Not switching over onto that Mei as Aramea keeping that shield line up very forward as we're going to be seeing kills traded on the backside. It looked like there was a flank coming in there by Team Weebstick, but instantly outflanked, out DPS'd, out rotated and taken down instantly. Energy Being is now breaking it down as best as he can to try and secure a little bit more of a teamfight advantage going into this. Rek jumping forward, tactical visor instantly being channeled by Rooty once again. He's got the nano visor, is going to be using those aimbots, and he has just toggled, but let's see who if he can get anyone else. But it looks like the rest of the team are confirming the kills for him. Rek and VK are now the only people left.
Here we go, Bastion.
Stall time. Bastion now coming out. We're gonna have to see where he sets up. The left clicking will intensify at some point shortly, I guarantee that. But this point is gonna be going as four men now instantly just pushing this point, and we are up at the last section as Katyusha on that Bastion doing what he can. This is the nano Bastion now instantly taken down as Aramea
no
hits
mercy.
Him in the face. That is one way to completely break your machinery. Just smack it with a big hammer or fix your machinery, who knows. But Rooty on the backside of this fight is just going to be doing some more work as he's confirming kills left, right, center, and that's 3 minutes 40 left on that round completion.
I think it really shows whose home map this was. Magic Mushrooms, essentially. Like, they clearly knew what they were doing and how they were going to respond to how they were going to attack each point individually. They had a game plan, they executed it well. Brilliant play. And we're going to round 3, but all they need to do is take the first point, I believe.
You believe in an overtime push is the real question? Oh no, there will be no overtime push. I completely forgot that.
No, there won't be an overtime push. This is a hybrid map.
3 minutes and 40 seconds to take this first point. We did see them taking it in about 2 minutes in the last round. So you have to expect that they're going to be able to do it, but
we are seeing some cheese.
How should Team Weebstick respond to this situation?
Cheese. They should. They weren't. They tried to stand the hill, didn't work. Cheese it. Which is what they're doing. They've got a Symmetra, they've got a Mei, they've got a Bastion. And we're seeing a pretty straightforward comp. We're not seeing a dive comp come out from Team Magic Mushrooms. So it might actually work. I want it to work. Come on, Bastion. Let's keep a tally of how many people die to Bastion. So far, we're at 1. No, wait,
and that
none.
Was the Bastion himself.
Yeah. So far, we've not got any. Just gonna zoom in on this Bastion. They've got the Mercy. Okay, Reinhardt, back off. Reinhardt, just hide in the corner and shield your Bastion. Do it for the stream. The YouTube channel. The viewers. Do it for the viewers.
We are going to be seeing that Mei that we so wanted in this last game as well, but Bastion set up around the side, instantly going to be trying to put some damage down onto that Reinhardt shield, defusing this first push already, but that's only 10 seconds. You have to expect that the team of Mushrooms will be able to respond to this in kind very shortly. They've proved that they are very coordinated.
One down.
They know how to respond. Aramea is going to be jumping into the backline, instantly taken down by Rek and that Bastion as well. This left clicking doesn't get any better than this. Roki on that Reinhardt pushing forward, barrier going down now, just gonna have to recharge as Rooty and Jonsoi are pushing through this point, trying to get some chip damage down, trying to charge their ults and trying to find an answer to this Bastion pick. Bastion of which now just repositioning.
Yeah, they're almost at a teleporter as well. This cheese may in fact work and we may be seeing an oasis. Oh, here we go.
But as we say that, we are going to be seeing Team Mushrooms going to be jumping through this high ground, assuming position as Rooty takes down Rek on the backside of this fight. They're now going to be getting the advantage as we are going to be going nice and tranquil here as Energy is doing his best to provide the energy that the rest of this team need to hold on to this point. The team now pushing through the high ground down onto this stair position, but Skowroki getting the better of them. Hammers don't get much better than this when they're swung in such small environments, especially a hammer of that size. As this team is now going to be holding this point from the first and second pushes.
Oh no, Bastion is, I believe, at four. I can't remember if it's four or five. I think it's five final blows. So, you know, keep it up, Bastion. We want to see you succeed.
But keeping it up is currently what Team Mushroom have been doing for the rest of this series so far. They're going to be going back to the standard hold that we saw earlier on. Going to be trying to do as much work from that far as we can. But Skowroki just going to be taken down instantly as VK also pushed onto the floor. We're going to be seeing Systems at Max coming through now from this Pharah, who instantly takes down that Bastion, channeling that Rocket Barrage and finishing off the rest of the team. This is the res coming through from Morgetz now. Morgetz could be holding this point, but it's going to also be freeze time coming through onto this point, keeping it cool and doing whatever they can, almost taking down the Morgetz on the backline, but Ruki finishing off that kill. Wybe and Aramea, the only people left here, as Pharah raining damage down once again, and that's a backflip coming out from Mei. I did not know she was that athletic. VK now challenging onto that Pharah, taking her out of the sky with some laser beams. Energy slept on the outside at this point as Koivupena is going to be just chomping through. Morgetz instantly pulled in by that Roadhog of Jonsoi, who's got that hook to just pull her in, instantly execute her on that point. Skowroki keeping this line forward as VK is just trying to fry people on the back of this point. VK going purple here. Will anybody be able to finish her off, though, is the main question. As Jonsoi now going whole hog. Whole hog finishing off that Bastion almost instantly on the back of this point as three people are cementing this point now. And it looks like this is going to be the first point take, unless the team can get there as soon as possible. Morgetz now jumping through, but taken instantly down by the hammer. Arik going invincible at the second, but not for very long. Energy also channeling the invincibility, jumping onto this point. This stall could be going for a little while now, but 10 seconds left, and that is game.
There we go. That's match to game and match to Magic Mushrooms. There we go. Congrats to those guys. That was well played.
A very decisive game coming there from the team of Mushrooms, and fighting through the cheese may have taken a little bit longer than you might have expected, but taking it nonetheless in the end there. And what really swung that for you there?
First of all, this was a really good res. Is it the one? Yeah, this is the one I think it is. You see three reses come out, and you see everyone just ults come out, everyone gets mowed down. So honestly, I thought it was the Pharah pick. Ruti was playing very, very, very well on it, as was Wybe. They kind of swapped between who was playing what, but they were playing very well around their Pharah, and Wybe didn't really have an answer to it. I would have liked to see the Zen come out earlier. I'm not convinced by the Mercy with the Zen. I prefer Anna Zen. They can kind of protect each other. But yeah, honestly, I would say the Pharah. Wybe just didn't have an answer to it. Not commonly, and that's pretty much all I've got for now. There's a lot to talk about, but that's the sum of it, I think.
And as we did see, game there being won overall by Team 420 Magic Mushrooms, showing that they truly are magical coming into the Hollywood map. And thank you for inviting me along to actually cast this match alongside yourself, Sindane. Hopefully our viewers at home can enjoy this stream and the game that we've just had. I know I did.
Thank you all for watching, and good night.